So we have this Simone Resta, chief designer of Scuderia Ferrari, head of the Malaysian Grand Prix, let you know what kind of stress is offered by a track like this for both chassis and the engine.
A track like Malaysia is generating a lot of thermal stress on the car, on the whole car, and you know, the chassis and the power unit. And we need to operate at an higher ambient temperature than Australia. And we need to guarantee the reliability for the package as well as a good performance level.
That leads to the eternal trade-off between aerodynamics on one side, the efficiency on one side, and the need for more cooling on a track like that. How do you cope with that?
This is our usual business, and we always try to optimize the most of what we got available on a certain track. In this particular case, of course, we need to guarantee on one end the reliability and the performance for the power unit, on the other end also a good performance level for the aerodynamic platform of the car. So we try to optimize the best lap time for our package in these conditions.
Jay Salison, now technical director, just said that some parameters of the Sepang track come very close, very similar to those of the previous race in Melbourne. Still, we have a different characteristic in that Sepang offers two very long straights. Do you think the SF15T can cope well with the kind of high-speed sections?
In our business, nothing is absolute, but all is relative to what the others can do onto a certain track. It's very early days in the season, and it's not clear where every car and every team does operate in terms of performance. From the very early days, we can see that we've shown a good top speed in Australia, as well as a good race pace in race condition. So we hope to maximize, let's say, these potentials, both on top speed and on race pace also in Malaysia, in a track that is also showing generally an higher tyres degradation during the race.
And finally, we came out of Melbourne with a podium finish for Sebastian, despite some glitches in qualifying and the race. Do you expect such a result could be feasible also in Sepang?
It has been a good start, and as you said, we have had this unfortunate DNF with one of our two cars. For Malaysia, we'll be trying to stay closer to Mercedes at the beginning of the race and put on them as much pressure as we can.